name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to make a saturated calcium hydroxide solution. For this experiment, we're going to need quite a bit of equipment. For start, we're going to need a graduated cylinder, a beaker, and we would like to close this beaker with some kind of lid. I am using a petri dish for that purpose today. I am also going to need a scale with a weighing boat, and should I need some assistance with scraping or extracting material, I will need a spatula for that. There will be some filtration, and depending on the equipment available to you, you may do a Buchner filtration or a gravity filtration. For the Buchner filtration, should you go that route, you will need a Buchner flask, a Buchner funnel, the appropriately sized filter paper, and you will also need a rubber hose along with a vacuum connection. Should you go the gravity filtration route, you're going to need, depending on your conditions, different materials. You can use a stand with an O-ring, a funnel, filter paper, and a beaker, or you can use a makeshift option that you can do at home. And that will include an Erlenmeyer with a funnel and a fairly large filter paper. At the end, you will need to dry the contents of your filter paper, so you will need a source of heat and something to place your filter paper on. So for that purpose, you're going to use a watch glass and ideally a hot plate. Now, the optional equipment for today is going to be a laser pointer. And we're going to use this to test the Tyndall effect and determine whether our saturated solution is indeed a solution or a heterogeneous mixture. For our materials, we're going to need a lot less. We're going to use some calcium hydroxide and some deionized water. If you do not have calcium hydroxide easily available to you, then you can make it from the precipitation reaction between calcium chloride and sodium hydroxide. So let's get started. First, we're going to measure out 1 gram of calcium hydroxide in a beaker. So I will turn on my scale, place a large beaker. I am using a 400 milliliter beaker for this experiment. I will tear it, and then I will use my calcium hydroxide and measure out 1 gram of it. And I have exactly 1.00 grams, but if you measured a little bit more or a little bit less, that's okay. Just make sure that you record the exact amount that you weighed. Next, I am done with my scale and I'm ready to move on to my volume measurements. I am going to attempt to dissolve the 1 gram of calcium hydroxide in approximately 300 milliliters of deionized water. It is approximate because we won't know the exact volume, but we want to have a good estimate for that. So I'm using a 100 milliliter graduated cylinder. My first volume measurement is 99.8 milliliters. My second volume measurement is 99.9 milliliters. And I will do this one more time. My third volume is 98.8 milliliters. Once my calcium hydroxide is combined with the water, I can do a couple things. I can stir it really well with a stir bar. I could put it on a stir plate with a magnetic stir bar. I can manually stir it with a stirring rod, or I can just let it sit and it will eventually dissolve as much as it can. The fastest option is to stir it and then wait and let the excess calcium hydroxide settle. So for today's experiment, I'm going to stir my solution with a stirring rod. Ideally, we would do this for at least 2 to 3 minutes and then wait for the calcium hydroxide to settle to the bottom. At that point, our filtration is going to be a little bit easier and it's more likely that we will end up with a clear solution at the end. Now I'm going to set my solution to the side and let it settle while I prepare myself for the next step, which is filtration. For Buchner filtration, I'm going to use a Buchner flask that has a sidearm. This will connect to the rubber hose that will be connected to the vacuum line. The Buchner funnel will have a filter paper inside it. So I will select one filter paper and make sure that it fits my Buchner funnel. Then I will place it on the flask and my Buchner setup is ready for the vacuum filtration. If I choose to go with the gravity filtration route, then I will take my Erlenmeyer flask, my funnel, and then I will take my filter paper, fold it in two, again in two. And then I will open it on one side so that on one side the paper has one layer and on the other side it has three layers, and I will slide it into the funnel. With both setups ready, the next step is to filter our solution. The other important consideration as we're doing the filtration in the process of making a saturated solution is that at the end of our filtration process, normally we would wash our precipitate. But in this case, because we're aiming for a saturated solution, it is crucial that we abstain from washing our solid. So as soon as all the mixture goes through the funnel, regardless of whichever one we choose, we need to stop. Because what we are looking for is the collection of the solution that goes through the filter paper, and we will need to know the mass of the solid that will be left over. So if a little bit of our material is stuck on the filter paper, that is okay. If we add more water, that is going to dilute our saturated solution and it defeats the purpose. I have completed my vacuum filtration of the calcium hydroxide solution that I made. So because I already worked with the beaker that contains the original heterogeneous mixture, I will need a clean beaker, or I can clean this and dry it and move forward from there. I brought in another 400 milliliter beaker. And now when I remove the Buchner funnel, I can transfer my solution from the Buchner flask into my 400 milliliter beaker. And to avoid any unnecessary contact with the air, I will put a lid on it and I will consider this as a saturated solution. Next, I will extract the filter paper with the calcium hydroxide that we collected through the filtration that did not dissolve in our 300 milliliters or approximately 300 milliliters of water. I will transfer it onto a watch glass and then place the watch glass onto a hot plate so that it may dry and I may be able to determine the mass of the recovered calcium hydroxide. For that purpose, I'm going to use a watch glass and a spatula. Circle around the filter paper and coax it out of the Buchner funnel. If there is a little bit of calcium hydroxide left in the Buchner funnel, I can scrape it off and place it on top of the filter paper. Once all my calcium hydroxide has been transferred, and I will be realistic that some material may have been lost in the transfer process, I will place my watch glass on the hot plate. I will keep it on the watch glass on gentle heat until the paper becomes dry and the solid becomes powdery. At that point, I will record the mass of the recovered calcium hydroxide from this process. And for our optional equipment, today we're going to use a laser pointer. According to the Tyndall effect, if we have a solution, meaning a homogeneous mixture, then the path of the laser beam should not be visible through the solution. However, if we have a heterogeneous mixture with very small particles floating in our liquid, then we will see the path of the laser beam. So let's see if we were successful in making a solution. And I will turn on my laser. And I do not see the path of the laser beam, which means that today, we were successful in making a homogeneous mixture or a solution. And we can consider this our saturated calcium hydroxide solution. It has been approximately 20 minutes or so, and it appears that our filter paper with the recovered calcium hydroxide on top is completely dry. And I can tell that because the paper seems a lot more rigid, and that is due to the dehydration. So at this point, we completely turn off the hot plate, and we very carefully wait a couple minutes before the watch glass is cool enough to touch. At that point, we can transfer it off the hot plate onto the surface. But should we be in a rush, it is important that we treat hot glass with adequate care, and we use tongs to extract it from the hot plate, and we use a wire gauze to place it on to avoid any kind of breakage in the process. For the final step in the process, we will need to measure the mass of the calcium hydroxide that we recovered. So we're going to take our scale, turn it on, place our weighing boat on top, and tear it. Then we extract our filter paper with the calcium hydroxide on top. We gently scrape off the calcium hydroxide. The gentle scraping will help remove the calcium hydroxide, but it will not facilitate the removal of cellulose, which is our filter paper. When we observe that there is a little bit of calcium hydroxide on our watch glass, we can transfer that over as well. And what we find is that we recovered 0.75 grams of our calcium hydroxide.